phytoplankton are the ocean's primary producers. Single-celled algae at the bottom of the food chain that photosynthesize using the sun's energy, just like plants on land. Harmful algae are a group of phytoplankton classified by their toxic or harmful effects on humans, shellfish, marine mammals, seabirds, and fish. A bloom occurrence happens when water conditions are just right and a harmful algal species reproduces and dominates the phytoplankton community in a given space. Harmful algae are not necessarily toxic, although many of them do produce toxins causing various illnesses or death, impacting marine mammals, seabirds, and human health. HABs can also cause fish kills by clogging or irritating their gills. Other algae can take over the water surface, casting a shadow on the life below and preventing access to valuable sunlight for plants like seagrass. Because of these biological impacts, HABs subsequently have a huge economic impact on people as well. For example, shellfish and fish that become toxic or die as a result of HABs means a loss of money for the people that sell them to restaurants and grocery stores. When there are beach or shellfish harvesting closures due to HABs, businesses that rely on tourists lose a lot of money too. NOAA scientists and their research partners are working to minimize biological, cultural, and economic impacts by learning to predict when HABs occur, monitoring new blooms, and developing ways to control them and keep us safe. In order to study these harmful algal blooms, the scientists first have to collect water samples. Our next video in this three-part series will illustrate some basic sampling techniques scientists use to collect and study harmful algal blooms.